Thank you. I do not want to get out of my sleeping bag. It's too cozy. Oh, but I have to. Shit! Oh, this isn't good. Oh, this is not good. Thank God for that. Whew. All right, everyone. Well, that concludes my trip out to the Naturalist Basin in the High Uintas. I squeezed one last trip in before the roads become impassable during the winter. Enjoy some of the sights from Mirror Lake Highway as I wrap things up and tell you a few more details about the trip. Temperatures. They're important, especially when it's cold. At night, it dipped into the 20s. And during the day, it was in the 40s, mid-40s or so. And that's without the wind chill. It's tough to get accurate information in regards to weather sometimes. And I checked several websites, and some said that the wind chill could feel like 9 degrees or 2 degrees, but nonetheless, I managed to stay warm enough during my trip. At times, my hands and feet would get cold, but nothing unmanageable. You might also notice that I'm actually outrunning a storm here in these clips. I'd checked my Garmin inReach and was debating leaving a day earlier, but decided to base camp right at the junction of the Highline Trail and the Naturalist Basin Trail, just so I'd have a shorter hike out on the last day, because the storm was supposed to come in around 2, and I don't think it really came in until around 4. By far, the biggest challenges were the trail conditions, which were a hellish combination of snow, ice, water, mud, and rocks. How did I forget this trail was super rocky? Other joyous challenges of winter backpacking include boots wetting out and being wet for 2 days straight. Oh, and don't forget they'll freeze overnight, and your laces. I also faced a little bit of a condensation issue and had to dry out my sleeping bag during the day. It was just a little bit damp, not too bad. I took my time heading back down Mirror Lake Highway and made sure to stop at the Bald Mountain Overlook here, and enjoyed every last moment I could. The wind picked up and howled, but the sky opened up and the sun shined through, giving me one last awesome look at this wild and beautiful place. I think every previous backpacking trip I felt like I didn't want to leave, but this time I knew I had to. And while driving through Camas and Park City, I was relieved to be heading home. These conditions would not be fun in a tent. I wanted to thank everyone for watching my little adventure out to the Uintas. Really enjoyed exploring this place and feel so blessed that it's in my backyard. It was a blast. It's hard, but it's fun. So beautiful out there. I'd also like to encourage everyone to get out there and enjoy the outdoors. Remember, always practice leave no trace, and I'll catch you in the next one.
I am?
Yeah.
Shit.
Thank you for flying SJC.
Do you want the engine?
Huh?
Do you want the engine in it?
Sure, whatever you think is a good shot. Can you do the other way horizontal?
Water is room temperature. Unfortunately, we don't have ice. So if you'd like to help yourself, please come up and do so. If you have any questions, please let me know. Again, my name is Nikki. Thank you.